Can you believe it, Frank? We're about to see our first football game.
I can't wait to see our home team score a lot of touchdowns and eat a lot of food.
But I always wanted to know, where did foot bites actually come from?
Maybe people have the audacity to chop off the foots of people and call it football.
No wonder why they call it that. But seriously, that would be too graphic to some people.
I mean, you do have a point.
Let's look at the origins of the football before we leave for the game.
Okay, Derek.
Oh my god, I really love this show. I could be watching this show all day and not give a damn.
Scott, you mind coming here for a second?
Yes, Lizzie?
I found this dance on TikTok, and I feel like, as a group, we need to try it.
What is this dance about?
It's a group of four people dancing to Everybody Dance Now from C+C Music Factory, which featured Freedom Williams.
Oh my god, I love that song very much. It gets me pumping all the time. Can I see the video?
Sure.
That sure looks fun, we definitely need to try it.
I know, I will go and alert the others. Guys, come down here, we got something to show you.
What is it?
There is this dance trend on TikTok that you have to see.
I can't wait to see what it is. Wow, this song is making me dance already. But I never knew the name of the song, unfortunately. It's called Everybody Dance Now, by C+C Music Factory, which featured Freedom Williams. Ah, I see. The question is, if we were to perform the dance, where would we do it?
I know, there's a park down the street that I always pass by.
You're right, the park is a great spot to do the dance.
Then what are we waiting for? Let's head on over to the park.
Okay, let's go. Wow, you actually picked a good spot.
Why, thank you, I really appreciate it. But anyways, want to start recording?
Yes. What about you guys? Yes.
Yes.
Then we are good to go.
I can't wait to see the outcome of this video. A 1, a 2, a 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm glad we got that out of the way.
Same, I even burned some cardio after doing that dance.
Now we just have to upload the video to TikTok, and we will become famous.
Sweet. Actually, I thought of something else. What if we upload it to TikTok and other social media sites? That way, the views will really blow up.
Great thinking, Scott. What would I ever do without you? I mean, what's the worst that can happen? What was that?
I have no clue. I don't know what they want from us, but I will record the event just in case something bad happens.
Yes, I got a picture of them. Now we can show the world what idiots they are.
Nice work, James.
Who the hell are you?
That is none of your concern. We're about to take over your TikTok.
Now first off, you can't steal people's work. That will make you look like a thief, and that's illegal. Now leave us alone.
Well, here's the thing, Missy, I can actually find a way to hack into your TikTok account to replace you two with myself and James.
You heard her. Leave us alone. We don't want anything to do with you.
Shut up, LeBron, or you're next.
First off, that was racist, and second, my name is not LeBron.
My name is LeBron. Yeah, whatever, you old hack.
I'm going to say this again, we don't want anything to do with you, so for the last time, leave. U.S. Alone.
Fine, you win, we'll leave now. But first, what's that on your shirt?
Where?
Ha, you actually fell for it.
Hey, that wasn't funny.
You wouldn't do that to a woman, won't you?
Oh, you asked for it.
Ow, that really hurt.
You two will definitely pay for this.
Oh, bring it on.
Oh wow, these guys are stronger than I imagined. Samir and Jessica, I need you two to do a big favor. Go find someone in the park to tame the situation while I try to fend off these bad boys. Right on it, Scott.
Anything for you, Scott.
Now let's see. Maybe that man can help us.
Can I help you guys?
Our friends Scott and Lizzie are getting attacked by two men over there.
Oh my god, I know those guys. They're the ones that just won my giveaway today.
Wait, you have a giveaway?
Yes, every month, the producers of the show, or Close Bot, host the giveaway, with the prize being VIP seats to a live tapping of an episode. But the way they're showcasing themselves, they don't even deserve it at all.
I agree with you, but in my opinion, it should go to Scott, because he's a huge fan of your show.
Wow, I can't believe I have a huge fan of my show, this really means a lot to me. Don't worry, I will be handling the situation and I will make sure these folks don't get their prize. By the way, allow me to introduce myself, I'm Derek. Not only I'm one of the actors on Boy Plus Bot, I'm also the executive producer of the show.
Wow, I didn't know you're the executive producer.
Crazy, right? I feel like I'm Danny DeVito at this point, because not only did he play M.R. Wormwood in 1996, he was also the director of the film.
Not gonna lie, 1996 was one of the best years for movies, or anything in the 90s in general.
Exactly, but hey, this is why you should pay attention to the end credits, because you might actually learn something.
With you here, I'm learning something every day.
I never been a teacher in my entire life.
Well, you're doing a great job.
Thank you.
You're most welcome. Anyways, I'm Samir, one of Scott and Lizzie's friends.
It's a pleasure meeting you, Samir.
And I'm Jessica, also one of Scott and Lizzie's friends.
It's also a pleasure meeting you, Jessica. And this is my robot friend, Frank.
It's a pleasure meeting you too.
So what are you waiting for? Are you all ready to end this once and for all?
Oh, we were born ready.
That's the spirit. Let's do this. Alright, everyone break it up. So what on earth is going on here?
Well, so this couple decided it was a good idea to harass us and treat us like animals. He also told us that they would kill our families if we didn't shut up.
Yeah, and the man told me that I was fat, even though I'm big boned.
That's not true at all.
Shut the hell up or you're getting it again.
Alright, enough. Based on your body language, I don't think you're telling the truth, so I'll ask one of these folks over there to see if you're actually telling the truth. Oh my, what's wrong?
I was really abused. And her T Todd A.
I'm really sorry you had to experience that today, come here.
Thank you, I really needed that.
You're welcome, so tell me, what happened?
So me and my friends were doing a TikTok of a dance that was from a song called Everybody Dance Now by C plus C Music Factory, which featured Freedom Williams. When Scott and myself were trying to post the video to social media, these two guys approached us, claiming that they were gonna hack my TikTok account and replace us with them. We said no and then they harassed and assaulted us like animals, and not humans. So that's when my friend called Samir and Jessica to find you, And we got it all on video for the record.
At least that's the best thing you could do. Can I see the footage?
Sure.
Thank you. Now let's watch it. Oh yeah, this behavior is totally unacceptable. But before I talk to them, I'm going to talk to your friend. Your friend told me that he's a huge fan of my show.
Yeah, and he told me that you are the funniest person that he has ever watched.
Oh, he's too kind. I'm going to speak to him now. Hey, I'm heard you're a huge fan of my show.
Oh my god, Derek. Yes, I am a huge fan of your show, and god, you're the funniest person I ever watched.
Why, thank you. It really means a lot to me.
You're welcome.
So what on earth happened?
So I was basically peacefully doing a TikTok with my friends, and these two guys approached us. Then they harassed us, called me LeBron, and then assaulted us. I tried to defend myself, but since they were so strong, I couldn't do it, and if you were there, I didn't want to make a fool out of myself.
Trying to defend yourself does not make you a fool, but hey, since you're a huge fan, I don't have to get mad at you.
Wow, thank you very much. It really means a lot to me.
Anything for you, brother.
There's one thing I must tell you before you go talk to those folks.
What is it?
Well, one of the guys took a picture of us. I have a feeling that they were going to hack the picture to make us look ugly.
Now I got all the evidence I need. But before I talk to them, I'm just going to say that I am giving you the giveaway prize.
I didn't know there was a giveaway prize. What is it?
VIP seats to a live taping of an episode, but since you were brave enough against those guys, I will try to make it extra special.
Wow, VIP seats for an episode, and you're going to try to make it special? Thank you so very very much.
You're welcome. Now if you excuse me, I will have a talk with those guys. I will get to the special part with you later.
Go get them, Derek.
So I got word with these folks right there, saying you took a picture of them and tried to hack the picture to make them look ugly, is that true? Let me see the picture.
Fine.
Thank you. Now let's see. Oh my god, I can't believe you guys would do such a thing. Do you realize this can lead to many suicides a year?
We were so caught off guard, we didn't mean to hurt anyone.
That doesn't give you the right to harass, make racist comments, and assault others. Not only that, but I saw everything when I was in the woods.
Oh shit, I did not see you there.
And I decided what to do with your giveaway prize, because not only I'm one of the actors of the show, I'm also the executive producer.
Oh shit, that's even worse.
So because of that, I will be taking away your giveaway prize and hand it off to one of my biggest fans of the show.
No, you can't do that. We worked extremely hard on that.
Yeah, you don't know how long it took us to win it.
I can, and I just did. I already notified the police already for your actions.
No, please, we don't want to go to jail, we were just having fun.
I'm sorry, but life is not fair, and yeah, you will have more fun when you two are in jail, but that's not the only one you're receiving, because we will come up with a punishment, just for you two. I will be right back after discussing the punishment. So Scott, I have a big favor for you, you will decide what punishment these two should face.
Okay, but first off, I love your short segment show, Face the Humiliation.
Why thank you, I really enjoy doing it.
And I really enjoy watching it. So here's my idea.
I really love your idea, I will not tell them the whole thing, but I will tell them that the punishment is in the studio where Boy Blue Spot is filmed. Thank you so much for that idea.
You're welcome.
Also, don't tell anyone but your friends this, but forget about the VIP seats, because I'm inviting you and your friend as special guests to face the humiliation because of your viral sensation, which is something I never done before.
Oh my god, that's better than the VIP seats. This is the best day of my life. Did you hear that, Lizzie? We're going to be special guests on the show.
I literally can't wait for that to happen.
Thank you so much for all your help.
No, thank you for sticking up. Okay, we have decided on your punishment. We won't tell you what it is, but it is going to be held in the studio where Boyklosbot is filmed.
We hope it's not bad.
You'll have to wait and see. Anyways, we will see you two in a couple of minutes.
Have fun.
Let us teach you a lesson on not treating people with respect.
Man, I can't believe this is happening to us.
I know. It's like doing one thing, then karma hitting you back.
Can this day get any worse?
I can't believe our friends are going to be on face the humiliation of special guests.
Yeah, but I also can't wait to see who gets humiliated.
Same, we just have to wait and see. Oh, it's starting.
Thank you very much. Welcome to Face the Humiliation, the show where consequences lead to the ultimate prize. Tonight, we have two guests that did the unthinkable, harassing two folks while using racist remarks, and us outing them like animals, while threatening to hack one person's TikTok account. Yeah, crazy right? And now that they are in the studio, they are about to pay the ultimate prize, so with that out of the way, please welcome, Travis and James.
Oh god, I really don't like this.
You should, you don't need to introduce yourselves because we all know what happened, so, are you ready to get humiliated?
No.
Well, that's too bad. Now, before the show, we asked a random member what your punishment should be, and they told me that you two should sound like elephants. How do you like that, audience?
No, we don't want to sound like elephants. That sounds so stupid.
Do you two want to get humiliated more?
No.
No.
Then do it.
Alright, here goes nothing.
God, these guys are sounding like idiots.
Yeah, that's like the funniest segment we ever saw.
So, did you two learn your lesson?
Yes.
Good. So currently the police are waiting outside the studio to take you away, and during your arrest, the studio is going to file a restraining order against you two, and when you get out of jail, if one of you stand within 100 feet within the studio's territory, you will be executed. Now, leave the studio, or else the security will escort you out. Well, we love to see people go to jail as their consequence, am I right, guys? Ladies and gentlemen, this just in, I never done this before, but we have special guests on the show, if any of you know, they're famously known for their TikTok dance video, as well as the ones who fought off against the two guys that just left the studio, with the views being skyrocketing as we speak, so with that, please welcome, Scott and Lizzie.
Oh my god, this is actually happening, and I'm not even dreaming.
You're totally right about that. I can't wait to see them when they come home.
Welcome to the show.
Thank you for having us.
So I heard you are a huge fan of my show.
Yes, I've been watching your show since the pilot episode came out.
That's amazing. What's your favorite moment on the show?
I love the part where you and Frank do the nacho dance.
Every time we dance to that, we always end up having nachos. So about that altercation with those two guys, what was going on in both of your minds?
Well, I was thinking, maybe if we leave them alone, or tell them to leave, they won't bother us anymore. But since they attacked us, we were like, we got to show them who's boss.
And when we were attacked, we had to remain in a calmly manner, because violence is never the answer.
You've heard them, guys. Violence is never the answer. So I have heard rumors that you two are like a couple. Is that true?
Well, we done a lot of things together over the years. Maybe we can expand that over a bit if we want.
That's actually pretty amazing. Who has the strongest connection?
As a matter of fact, I am the one that has a stronger and deeper connection to my friend.
Excuse me, but can I at least say one thing to Lizzie?
Go right ahead.
Lizzie, no matter what happens in our lives, you're still going to be one of my closest friends, and because of that, you're one of my dearest friends I ever had.
Oh, you're so sweet.
Well, it was a pleasure having you two here. Thank you so much for having the time to join us. And before you leave, I just want to remind you, if any of you would be interested in having a so-called wedding, like being pronounced boyfriend or girlfriend, let me know. But again, it was an honor having you here.
Thank you, Derek, and thank you, everybody.
Mom, we really love when miracles happen. That sound means we are out of time for tonight. I will like to thank the audience, wherever at home or in the studio, for watching this episode, and Scott and Lizzie for joining us. Join us next time as we bring in more troublemakers to face the ultimate consequence. And remember, don't take drugs, kids, because you don't want to end up like the folks who are currently in prison.
100%. Wow, you guys did amazing.
Yeah, you two took it like champs.
Thank you, guys. We really appreciate it. But Lizzie, there's something I want to tell you about. I want to say that after all the things you've done to me, and I done to you, I love you very much.
Oh my god, Scott, I never expected for you to say that to me. I never been loved by someone before.
I love you, Lizzie.
I love you, Scott.
I bet they were right when they say love at first sight.
I totally agree with you there.
Lizzie, want to make that call to that wedding?
Absolutely. I want to make another miracle happen.
Okay, let's make that call.
Hello?
Hi, this is Scott from earlier.
Scott, what's new, my friend?
Me and Lizzie would like to plan that wedding you were talking about from earlier.
Okay, I will get everything planned. I will see you guys in a couple of minutes.
See you soon. Okay, we should be heading down to the studio. Hope everything goes great for you too.
Like I said before, you two are going to do great. Trust us, we've been waiting for this moment all our lives.
We interrupt what you're doing for this special announcement. Just recently, we met up with Scott and Lizzie, and now, they decided that they want the wedding to happen. So, without further ado, please welcome back, Scott and Lizzie. It's a pleasure having you back.
We can't wait for this to happen.
Trust me, we're going to make it special, alright. But where did I put that book I'm supposed to read to you?
Oh, I'm sorry, Derek. I had it with me the whole time.
No worries. Can I see it?
Sure.
Thank you. Alright, now let's get this started. We are gathered here today to witness the joining of two lives. This is the relationship celebration of two people who are special to you. These two separate people have chosen this special time and place to be together. The decision to be together is not entered into lightly, but rather is undertaken with great consideration and respect for both the other person and oneself. You as friends and family are able to celebrate with Scott and Lizzie, in the making of this important commitment. The heart of togetherness is the taking of another person in that person's entirety, with the good times and the bad times, the sad moments, the happy ones and the taking of that person as our friend and companion for life. It is not something that just happens, a good relationship is created. In a good relationship, the little things are big things. Do not take one another for granted. Do things for one another, not with the attitude that it is a duty or sacrifice, but in the spirit of joy and giving. Develop the capacity to forgive and forget. Do not look for perfection in your partner. Create an atmosphere in which each of you can grow. The essence of togetherness is love, and love is one of the highest experiences that we as human beings can share. Love adds meaning to our lives. One of the greatest things we can do is to love another human being as a boyfriend or girlfriend love each other. Relationships symbolizes the sharing of two lives. Yet this closeness will not diminish the character of being of either individual partner. As your relationship continues to grow, your understanding of each other will continue to expand. Time and togetherness will gain for each of you a deep knowledge of each other. Today's relationship ceremony signifies the beginning of a lifetime of wonderful human experiences to be shared as a boyfriend and girlfriend. Now please face each other and hold hands. Now we celebrate the love that Scott and Lizzie have for each other and as family and friends you give social recognition to their intention to permanently accept the other by requiting your relationship vows. Scott, do you take this woman to be your wedded girlfriend?
I do.
Will you love her, honor and keep her, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and keep yourself only to unto her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Lizzie, do you take this man to be your wedded boyfriend?
I do.
Will you love him, honor and keep him, in sickness and in health, forsaking all others, and keep yourself only unto him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
You have vowed to be loyal and loving toward each other. May you keep these vows which you have made here today. May you comfort each other, share each other's joy, console each other during times of trouble, and help each other as boyfriend and girlfriend. May you encourage each other in whatever you set out to achieve. And, most importantly, may you continue to love one another forever. Scott and Lizzie have formalized their vows and the bond between them in your presence and in mine, it hervore, by the powers vested me as the executive producer of Boy Plus Bot, and everyone else here in the studio, pronounce you, boyfriend and girlfriend. You may kiss each other. And not only that, they are officially going to be permanent actors on my show, playing as our next door neighbors.
Wow, Scott, I can't believe this is happening to us.
Yeah, we definitely grew fame now.
Congratulations on your relationship and your casting. You two definitely deserved this.
This is clearly a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity, and we can't wait to start our first episode on the show.
Glad to see that. So, we will notify you when your first episode is going to start, but other than that, you're free to go.
See you soon for your first episode.
I'll see you later, Frank.
Same here.
Well then, I can't believe we saw a miracle happen, and now, I can finally go to bed peacefully.
Wow, I can't believe you're actually a couple for life. Yeah, I wouldn't think that we would find love interests in our lives.
While you two were gone, Samir baked something for you in the kitchen as a gift for all of us. Oh boy, we can't wait to see what it is.
Here it is, my homemade vanilla buttercream cake that I made myself.
Oh wow, that looks so yummy, the buttercream frosting looks like the most delicious part, can we have some?
I mean, it's your and Scott's cake, so go right ahead, go crazy with it.
Alright. Oh, this cake is goated as hell.
Why thank you.
Scott, you have to try this cake.
I heard that it has buttercream on it, so it must be good. Man, this is the best cake I ever tasted. Thank you so much, Samir. You're most welcome, guys. At least you enjoyed almost everyone's favorite cake. So Lizzie, now that we enjoyed the cake, what do you want to do next?
Actually, I have no clue what to do. I have an idea. How about we watch some episodes of Boy Plus Bot, and maybe after that, attempt to do the nacho dance together. I love your idea, Jessica. So Scott, do you want to watch a couple episodes of Boy Plus Bot, and after that, attempt to do the nacho dance as a whole?
Absolutely, because you're my nacho baby.
Ah Scott, what would I ever do without you?